models in the group? No? Right here? Okay, good. Thanks for making it, sir. Good to see you. So, what we're going to do for you, we do a lot of short form stuff, we do long form too. Today we're going to do short form. We're going to do a thing called director's cut. Actors have to audition all the time, all right? So this helps out in their auditioning process. So we here at the Go Comedy School of Acting guarantee each and every one of these guys and gals a job. So we have four people that are going to do a scene for you. Let's see what they have.
I don't know if we're going to survive this winter.
Guys, just need to man up. Alright? Act like you've never been through a winter before.
Don't you tell me to man up. This isn't a man's world. We're all equal in this fight.
You said this last year, okay? I got it recorded right here.
You said it last year in this fight.
See?
God, you know, this is supposed to be for a Shakespeare audition. That wasn't working out. Frank, we got your number. You can sit down. Anybody else in the crowd want to help us out? Anybody always wanted to be an actor? Actress? Nobody? All right, let's go with Preston here. Preston, come on out. And what's your favorite movie that's out there right now? Anybody?
Deadpool.
All right. And give us a different time period for Deadpool.
The French Revolution.
The French Revolution. Oh, I love that. French Revolution Deadpool. Let's see what they come up with. It's going to be good.
I do not care what you said. We will have our freedom. Let them eat cake with katanas! Hey, you guys like that? That was pretty cool!
Oh, I saw that.
That is what you get for trying to hold your people down.
I have a human factor.
You son of a...
That's awesome. Fourth wall breaking.
Freeze. Yeah, it was going pretty good until you killed the best actor on stage, which was Preston. Joe, you shouldn't have killed the poor guy. We got your number. How about Dan? Why don't you come up? And Scott, not bad, but we need a woman for that part that's coming up. So Laura's going to come up and help you out. So what's your favorite musical, Broadway or otherwise?
Fiddler on the Roof.
Fiddler on the Roof, okay. And give me a different time period for that.
2000s.
That's a very good time period. That's actually my favorite time period. Fiddler on the Roof in the 2000s.
I say, Denise, it's really hard to get cell phone coverage right now in these primitive times.
I'm fiddling on this roof.
Do you hear that? I've got an app that will help you.
That's cool.
It'll show you all your tabs. Not sure that's how a fiddle works. An app? What's that?
It's this.
Wow.
Yeah.
I just got an S7 Extreme. I feel like soon there'll be an app for everything.
Cut for a second. I thought this was going to be a musical.
We haven't got to the song yet.
Oh, you haven't got to the song yet?
There's an app for that. We're going to open it up.
We're working on the app. Okay,
remember, there's an app. For that.
Yep.
Doesn't matter if you still don't that.
Yep.
But wait, I see. There's a fiddler on the roof.
She
who
sees.
Wants to
she
play
sees.
With
there's
an
a fiddler on the roof.
And he wants to
on the roof.
Play.
That's me.
Fiddler on the roof.
This fiddler, he doesn't use a bow. Nope. He strums that fiddle like it's a little ute.
To you, says fiddler on the roof.
The fiddler on the roof. The fiddler on the roof.
That was pretty good, huh? What do you think?
Yeah.
This guy's like, oh man, give me a beer. He's got a thumb up. Okay, good. One thumb up. We got one thumb up, okay? We don't know where that thumb's been, but it's up. Anyway, we're going to do something called freeze tag. And how this works, you guys know this. Two actors run up here, start a scene. Someone from the back line yells, freeze! Runs out, bags the person, assumes the exact same position, starts a totally new scene. So with that being said, give me something that doesn't start with the letter T.
Ukulele.
I love ukuleles. And where are these two people?
Steamship.
Spain.
Where at?
Steamship.
Steamship. The steamship with the ukulele. Let's see what they got.
They desperately need this cargo of ukuleles.
We're running out of steam!
But we can't burn the instruments.
Just the ukulele.
You don't understand. Without music.
Freeze.
You know, I don't know,
please.
I don't have any of what you call money. I come from the future, a time where money is useless. We pay each other with gentle hugs.
You have any comments, any notes? Like, lay it on me.
Your sister. Your sister misses you a lot.
My God!
Hey, sis. I miss you a lot. How?
I just can't believe that I bought him with a bologna sandwich!
Yeah, I like bologna.
That's a really good deal. You feed him bologna and you sell him bologna.
Yeah. My bologna has a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R.
O-S-C-A-R? Oscar! Oscar Mayer bologna!
Yeah, what do you guys want?
I want some mustard on my Oscar Mayer!
Oh, I got some of that back down here. There you go.
Great.
Mr. Squidward, you're late again!
Hey, listen, alright? This pineapple is not big enough for all of us, alright?
It's not big enough for my nose, I tell you that.
Freeze! Let's up the ante a little. Anybody from the audience want to come in and help us up? Anybody up here? No? Okay, come on, let's go. Let's introduce, what's your name?
David Jakubowski.
David, okay, David's going to help us out. Did you see how that goes?
Okay.
That's your uncle. Okay, let's get your uncle out here. Let's start a scene with uncle. Give him a little time to develop. Okay, so we got David and Uncle Joe. That's Uncle Joe. He's moving kind of slow, but we're going to do a scene. And give us something for the scene to be about. Give me a world problem that's nonviolent. Presidential election. It could be violent, but yeah. Presidential election, and these are two... campaign reformers. Here we go.
I really like Donald Trump. I love his hair. What? Yes!
Are you crazy?
I don't have any hair. That's why I love his hair. He's got some. Wow!
Look what just happened just now. Right now. This is what you get.
You had hair last week.
I know.
You voted for Hillary, and this is what happens.
Hey.
What?
Hey. Yeah, there's a storm coming, man.
Lightning.
You're more than welcome to join me in my house, you know?
Let's
got some coffee.
Let's go.
Oh, okay.
Let's go. Oh, wow. Thank you.
Yeah. It's
it's far away.
Get back in there.
I don't want it.
I'm not running a prison where you could just walk out the door anytime you want.
Why?
Donald Trump
sentenced you to prison after he took your hair. And as president of this country, there's nothing we can do to stand against His Majesty the Trump.
You want it, you got it.
With my head with hair, long, beautiful hair, shiny, gleaming, stinging, fast and waxing. Give him down to there.
Hair!
Over like no longer.
Hair!
Dr. Know-It-All about your love life, money, presidential election is kind of overdone, but if you have a question about it, throw it out there. Who has a question for Dr. Know-It-All?
Why am I so lonely?
Why is this handsome young man so lonely? Dr. Know-It-All.
So,
it
seems
you
were
lonely.
So,
when
the
pitiful
sound
of
the
birth
of
your
soul
fell
out
of
the
earth,
moon,
sun,
that
Mars,
Pluto
is
beautiful,
baby.
Why
are
there
that's a story?
So
many
words.
Is
period. Okay, I said the period. Okay, what that note actually said was you need to take the black fingernail polish off your thumb. Girls don't like that. Okay? So change to red and you'll be good. Alright, one short question, boy. That was a novel. For Dr. Noah, who's got a question?
Should I move to Seattle?
Should this young lady move to Seattle?
Perhaps.
So,
but
can it?
Can
you
were
meant
not
leave?
Period.
Okay, one more question for Dr. Know-It-All on this side of the room.
How do you knit a sweater?
How do you knit a sweater? How do you knit a sweater? Good question.
First,
you
knit
with
the
sticks.
Okay. Apparently, you go out to the woods, pull a couple sticks off of trees, and that's how you knit. I wasn't really happy with that answer, so we got to go with one more. This young man here has a question. What is it? Okay, I got it. He's speaking to me in opera language. Will this young man ever be an opera tenor? Go.
Maybe.
Period.
Well, I can't add to that. Maybe if you keep that. That was very good, by the way. All right, one more question. Right here. This young lady has one. No, that guy has one. What's yours?
Should I get married?
Should he get married? Depends to who. Okay. No. Should he get married?
Well,
if
you
really love
this
woman,
then
you
should
run.
Yeah!
Bring
her
home.
Period.
I'm sticking with that thread. Okay, next thing we're going to do is 60-30-15-5-1. We got these three. You guys come up. Another actor train thing. They're going to do a scene in 60 seconds for you. So give me, I'll give you one word.
Space.
Space. The final frontier. Okay. Space. You're going to do a scene about space, and Dan is off stage. Okay, he's going to make an entrance just when he wants to start. Space, here we go. And we're going to do that in 60 seconds.
Wow! It's so free out here.
I know, I'm not even wearing a suit.
Connected to the ship.
You know, I think this is all in my brain.
Don't breathe so hard. You're blowing me away.
Oh, sorry about that.
Ground control to Maiden's home.
Can we make it back?
Ground control to Major Tom.
Okay, and see, that was 60 seconds. What do you think? They can do a little bit better, huh? Speak up.
You can drink.
All right, they can do a little bit better. Let's do the same scene in 30 seconds. You think they could do it?
Yes.
Yeah, can the audience do it? Yeah! Here we go. 30 seconds starting now. Go.
I didn't wear any suit.
We're going so hard.
I don't know if I'm going to make it back home.
You're blowing me away.
I'm sorry.
Planet Earth is blue and there's nothing I can do.
My mind.
And see, that's 30 seconds. I don't know. The audience says that you can do this in 15 seconds. What do you think?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Back off. Come on. We're good. And here we go. 3, 2, 1, go!
Whoa! We're not connected!
I don't want to shoot!
Subject to talk about. What is it?
Cantaloupe.
Cantaloupe. Just like that. Cantaloupe.
Cantaloupe.
And John needs a famous person before 1900. What? Hamilton. All right. We got Hamilton. All right. John's going to start and time him in a minute. And go.
Alexander Hamilton. He lived his entire life just so in the future a man could give birth to the greatest musical of our time. This man sacrificed everything. He gave up personal relationships to run for president, a position which has been shown to dramatically age men. Just knowing that someday someone would look on his life and say, I want to rap about you on stage for about 45 minutes, maybe an hour. I'm not really sure how long the musical is, but he knew to give it his all because Alexander Hamilton, he's a true American hero.
Hey, 1 minute, all right, good. Woo! Yeah! On this subject, here we go.
All right, everybody, very, very quiet. He's chasing me. He's taking the ladders, he's taking the rope, he's taking all the wood. I hope doggone town. He's gonna make sure that I don't get to his daughter and take her away to California. He doesn't like to get in a car and travel anywhere. So I just, oh my God, did you hear that? I think he's after me. Somebody hide me. Somebody hide me, please hide me. Wait, if I hide myself, he won't see me. He didn't even work when I was 6 months old. I guess I just went on.
And see, okay, Frank. Give me a job, sir.
Office
job? Good, because I'm looking for an office job. Thank you. Okay. Let's see who's worst office worker.
What do you mean they blocked Reddit?
No!
Tie in the shredder.
What comes after A? E? I'm hired.
N. fill up that we drop my pants.
Sorry, I can't talk now. Final four time.
Don't know whether that should get decaf or calf or just half calf, half decaf.
How many times can I poop and still get paid?